This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to show how to calculate the future value of an annuity using a TI-83 or TI-84 calculator. Here's the problem we're going to work with. This says, if you deposit $200 per month into an account that pays 6.5% compounded monthly, how much will you have after 5 years? Here's what the problem means. Let's say that every month you put $200 into an account. The account gets interest, which is compounded monthly. The interest rate is 6.5% per year. You do this for 5 years. The question is, how much money will you have at the end of that 5 years? So we have a future value formula that will tell us what this is. The future value is the amount of money you're going to have at the end of 5 years. The future value equals the payment. That's how much money you pay every month. In this case, it's $200. And we're going to multiply the payment by 1 plus I. I is the rate per period as a decimal. In other words, we want to take the rate per year, that's 6.5%, turn it into a decimal, 0.065, and then divide it by the number of periods. There's 12 compounding periods every year, so it's going to be 0.065 divided by 12. And then we're going to take that and raise it to the n power. N is the total number of periods we'll have. So it's going to be the number of years, 5 years, times the number of periods per year, which is 12. So N will be 5 times 12, or 60. Then we take that, subtract 1 from it, and divide that whole thing by I, which once again is the rate per period as a decimal. Okay? Now we're going to do this on the calculator. The big problem with doing it on the calculator is there's a lot of places to make mistakes, so we don't want to do this whole thing all at once. We want to start out, I'm going to start out with this I in the numerator and calculate that, and then we'll work from there. So I is the rate per period as a decimal. We want to take the rate per year. It was 6.5%. We'll enter that as a decimal, 0.065. And we have to divide that by the number of periods per year. It was compounded monthly, so we're dividing that by 12. Now we want that answer, this 0.0054, the number that keeps going. And we want to add 1 to that. So I've got that answer plus 1. And then we want to raise that to the n power. So we'll use the raise to button. That's going to raise our answer. And n is the total number of periods. So the total number of periods is the number of periods per year, which is 12, times the number of years, which is 5. 5 times 12 is 60. So we have the answer raised to the 60th power. Once we've got that, we want to subtract a 1 from it. So I'll take that answer and subtract 1. And now once we've got that, I'm going to take that and divide it by I. I, once again, is the total number of periods. I'm sorry, I is the rate per period as a decimal. So I want to divide. I'm going to have to use parentheses for this because I'm going to figure out I again. It's 0.065. That's the rate per year. Divided by 12. That's the number of periods per year. And we get 70.6739. Okay, so that amount times the payment, which was going to be $200 per month, should give us the future value. So we'll multiply that amount, that's 70.67, times 200, and I get $14,134.79. What this means is, if you deposited $200 every month into an account that paid 6.5% compounded monthly, at the end of 5 years, you would have $14,134.79. Okay? Take care. I'll see you next time.